GenePattern pipelines provide a simple method for recording and reproducing your analysis workflow. They can be designed to analyze a particular set of data, or constructed in such a way as to allow the person running the pipeline to provide their own data and set other analysis variables. More information about GenePattern pipelines can be found in the Concepts Guide at genepattern.org. To begin creating a new pipeline, select New Pipeline from the Modules and Pipelines menu. This displays the blank pipeline designer ready to begin a new pipeline. As suggested by the Editing Pipeline panel displayed on the right, a good first step in creating a pipeline is to fill in the basic pipeline properties. First, we give our pipeline a meaningful name. The description can be anything that describes the pipeline. Author should ideally be your email address. Privacy determines who will be able to see the pipeline. The version comment is anything you want to indicate about this version of the pipeline. Documentation can be any standard documentation file type, such as TXT, DOC, DOCX, PDF, or HTML. To commit each change, you can simply tab to the next property, hit Enter, or click outside the panel. Note that you can always return to the Editing Pipeline panel by clicking Properties next to the pipeline name. The next step is to add a module to your pipeline. For this pipeline, we'll start with Illumina Expression File Creator. To add this module, you can expand the Preprocess and Utilities category and click on the module, or use the search box on the upper left to select it and then add it to the pipeline diagram. Next, add Hierarchical Clustering, and then feel free to drag the modules to any positions you see fit. To indicate the flow of our pipeline, we must now connect the modules. We are going to be using the .gct output from Illumina Expression File Creator as the .gct input for hierarchical clustering. To accomplish this, we click and drag from the output of Illumina Expression File Creator to the input of hierarchical clustering. We now see an arrow illustrating the connection between the two modules. The details of this connection can now be seen in the Hierarchical Clustering Properties panel. If we now go to the Properties panel for Illumina Expression File Creator, we see that even though we've connected the modules, there is still an alert, informing us of the need for an input file, which is a required parameter. To supply an input file, we could attach a file to the module by uploading a data set, or we could set the parameter to prompt when run. What this will do is allow the person who runs the pipeline to upload an input file of their choosing when they run our module. If instead we were to attach a file here, users would only ever be able to run the pipeline with the file we uploaded. For this tutorial, we'll select prompt when run. We now check the other parameters to be sure they are set as we would like. Notice that the error message is now gone. Suppose that while editing, we remembered that we need to apply some normalization to our Illumina expression data before sending it to hierarchical clustering. So we add preprocessed data set to the diagram. We then remove the connection between Illumina expression file creator and hierarchical clustering by clicking on the end point of the connecting arrow, as the flow of data is going to change. Next, we drag preprocessed data set to a place that makes sense for us, and add connections from Illumina Expression File Creator to Preprocess Dataset, and from Preprocess Dataset to Hierarchical Clustering. Next, we open the Properties panel for Preprocess Dataset and verify that the parameters are set to our liking. Lastly, we check to make sure the parameters for Hierarchical Clustering are also set as we want them. As a side note, if we were to decide that we no longer wish to run Hierarchical Clustering after Preprocess Dataset, we could simply click the blue X in the top right of the module. For this tutorial, however, we will leave them both in. Now that we have completed our pipeline, we can choose one of the following options. Save the pipeline and continue to edit. Save the pipeline and continue on to the pipeline run page, or save and navigate to another location in GenePattern or log out, etc. For this tutorial, we'll click Save and Run, which takes us to the pipeline run page, where we see that, as configured, we can now provide a dataset of our choosing to be run through this pipeline. To find your pipeline from the home page, simply type the name into the search box on the left and select. This will, once again, open your pipeline run page. Before we conclude, It should be noted that there are two other common methods of creating pipelines in GenePattern. One method is to clone an existing pipeline. To do so, navigate to the Properties page for the pipeline you wish to clone, and click Clone. After choosing a name for your clone of this pipeline, you can edit the pipeline just as you can any other pipeline you own. You can also create pipelines which recreate a workflow you've already run. To do this, simply open the menu next to an output from a job you've run, and select Create a Pipeline. This then opens the Pipeline Designer, pre-populated with all of the modules, inputs, and parameters used to produce the result from which you created the pipeline. This concludes our introduction to the new GenePattern Pipeline Designer. More information about GenePattern and its pipelines can be found at genepattern.org.